Alright, so I'm hiding over here, away from the wind, so you can hear what I'm talking about. Me and Tom Korn over there are going to be widening this landing and making it a little more chunky. Now I'm going to walk into the wind. I've been soaking this dirt. I spent all day yesterday soaking and layering it.
Like it's a swamp now. It's beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Just kidding, that's just grass.
Yeah. Look at that sauce.
Oh, I can feel this dirt.
Ooh. I bet they're gonna love that wind noise.
Just wind it up. You can get a mic for that, can't you? 25 people comment like you have to get a mic.
We'll do 25 because I actually want to get a mic anyway. Let's go look at this bicycle over here. So I'm gonna be messing around with this guy now. It is Fazari LaSalle Peak. And it is absolutely beautiful. Carbon fiber frame, Lyric fork, super deluxe rear shock, GX drivetrain, I think. I don't know, maybe you call it Eagle drivetrain. It's got some Stratus wheels, some flow rims, Tom. My favorite tire up front, the Maxxis Minion. Race face bars are pretty sweet. I like how wide they are. Nice short stem. And this seat dropper is sweet. Is this a Fox, Tom? Someone told me it's Fox. I don't know what it is. There's no way it's a Fox. It would say Fox all over it. It's a transfer. I'll put whatever it is in there, but it freaking shoots up quick. Boom. And there's the 22-inch bike. That thing's sweet. Still sweet. Gonna ride both of them today. Tom's over here putting in the intensive labor. And I'm gonna pick up a shovel. All right, another update. Came up with an idea. So I'm gonna be down here so we're out of the wind. But Tom is digging out a berm that will go through these trees kind of like a goalpost. So you'll come off this landing right here. You land. You go here through this wheelbarrow. Around this turn. That way we're not freaking sending Tej into the freaking taco over there. This is where we're at on the piling the dirt. Pretty exciting there. I'm using the old stacking technique. We build a little ramp. You just drive up and keep stacking, building the ramp taller and taller. Tom's doing some gardening. Nice. We're kind of figuring out how to thread the needle through the tree there. Oh, because of that branch?
Yeah.
Nice. This will be sweet.
That's not though.
Her adjustments have been made. Let's see how she goes this time.
A little bit more dirt, not too much. We might build a quarter here. But not with the dirt. I'll probably build it out of wood or something. Because a dirt quarter would be way too much maintenance. Like, no way. So we're just going to goof around. Make it so we're not riding out into the street every time. But yeah, let's give her a roast. I'll try and go as high as I can.
Yep, get in there. Oh, it's starting from over there. He's hitting a tree. Shoulder check. Oh, my.
Well, it goes right here. I don't know why you stood right where I'm going.
I don't know. I expected you to go out there for some reason. Yes. Wow. So intense.
Yeah, I think that entrance needs to be pushed back a little bit. Because I almost hit. Well, I guess it doesn't help if these were poking out into my shoulder. I didn't really get a roast how I wanted.
Why did I come through there?
Yeah, both of our back wheels are riding on the flat ground. It looks terrible.
And now we're taking out the roller.
Oh, you caught me.
But this thing was robbing us of a little speed there, possibly.
I don't know if it was.
We'll find out. We're about to know. There's the roller and the jump. Yeah, it was a little close there, Tom. And then the berm is literally right on the roller.
Yeah.
You'll have to tell me how it feels to lift a carbon bike up the shed.
Oh yeah, I haven't jumped this bike off anything yet either.
Oh, there he is. There he goes.
Oh yeah, that's chill.
And the berm.
We tested everything.
Yeah, how'd it go?
It was good.
All right, hit it again. Hey, what's your PSI at, bud?
We're a little low there.
Yeah, I gotta pump her up for this high-speed hard pack stuff,
yep,
bud.
Yep. That was cool, though.
That was awesome. All right, do it. Right now, 22-inch challenge. You're all shook. You haven't hit it on a BMX bike yet. How many videos is it and you haven't hit it on your real bike?
I actually need a pump.
Yeah, you need some PSIs in there, bud.
But it's Sunday in Utah, so.
So everything's closed.
Yep.
Where's your 22? Get up on there.
Let's get up on the BMX
bike. Those forks are totally choppered.
Yeah.
Someone doesn't want to set the ladder. Well, that was great.
What was that?
It just slipped.
Did it slip?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Dude, BMX bikes are scary fast.
Yeah, you were cruising. You went flat a little bit, huh?
I was going slow. Like, I landed dumb on that and overjumped this.
That's what I'm saying. This needs to be bigger.
Yep.
The berm's kind of shaped crappy, so this is kind of just the test, but it seemed to work without the roller.
Give her a little tinkle.
Okay. Yeah, and then you crossed it again. Just tied a big old knot. What are you doing? You're letting the speed out. Why are you letting your speed out? Get out of there! Stop! Stop it!
Fine.
Jeez, bud.
Oh my god.
Letting all the speed out of your tire.
I'm trying to freaking slow down a little bit.
I know you're trying to slow down, you're not allowed.
Sunday afternoon, Tom.
Yeah, exactly. There's no sports on Sunday anymore, so you might as well make up for it right now.
Yeah,
that dog is hyped. You almost died.
Get back in there. Do another one. And then we'll dig. That feels nice.
So Tom smoothed it out over here. So he's making me hit it again. Super buttery now. Look at that.
How's that ruin it?
And you ruined the whole thing. It's all right. I won't even ride right there on that.
That's what we're testing, is to see if that even needs to be there, actually.
See how smooth. I guess it doesn't look that smooth, but it's way smoother. There's no way to get more speed than that, besides a bigger roll-in, of course.
Right.
But with that setup, there's no way.
Yeah, it probably isn't the best option.
If you think there's a better option, comment, because
I would like to know.
Yeah, I would really like to know. But so far, this thing gives you a ton of speed off of that thing. What are we showing them? Yes. Dude, 22s are sweet. Wasn't high enough. All right. Ooh. Oh yeah. I need to pay attention to his line. His line choice and where he goes. Like if he's gonna land and actually use the berm, or if he's gonna land and just cut straight through right there, you know. Or if he's gonna actually or if he's gonna go. This landing's honestly pretty decent. Pretty proud of this little jump, you know? Use the berm and then straighten out a little bit. You rode it a lot different. I think we're good. I think it's 100% perfect. It feels good. Nice. I forgot to film the berm. I forgot about it. Yo. That was rad.
But the jump feels good.
All right, we got a little bit more berm here. A little more dirt moved. But we got to test the alignment of this berm. We figured out how to pump up our tires with the pump we had, so we'll be sweet. Tire's not going to blow off the rim. So we're switching back to the full suspension.
This looks so rad. I love this apple tree. It's huge. Nice.
Oh, the berm's in a good spot, but it's soft.
Yeah, okay. As long as it's in the right spot, then we're okay. Yeah, you looked like you entered it okay.
It could be taller, though, but...
Yeah, we'll figure that out later, like, with time.
The bike did sweet, though.
The air wheel's on.
Yep. It's interesting how different the bike flexes, aluminum versus carbon.
I bet.
Little update for you guys. Tons of extra dirt over here now. Tom's over here chopping away. This berm's looking sweet. And we have broken through. This is the last of the dirt. We still have quite a bit. It's looking sweet. Like, it's looking like an actual berm. Another angle of the dirt pile. Oh yeah. Been watering as we go. Buried some crap in there too, some grass. But that's gonna be sweet. Everything's gonna get a little bigger. Check in a little bit. Here's a quick little update for you guys. Tom has been working a little bit. I went and got some food and came back. And this is what he's got. We've got much, much wider landing. So huge. Now I'm building up this side of the whole thing and kind of evening out everything. Give you some more angles here. Oh yeah. I'm gonna build up this side, stack it up a little higher. And then do the right side a little bit so that's kind of a U shape, and then fill in the inside and square it all off. I'll give you a little update in a little bit. Did you just go find that in the thing?
Yeah, he's f***ing trash hunting. F***ing trash panda.
The trash.
Are you hunting for trash? What did you find, Charles? Show him what you found.
Trash. Towel hanger. Very mid-century modern-esque.
Mid-century modern-esque?
Came with this too, dude.
What, did it come with hardware?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Then he said it was for towels, and I knew that you...
Some twirling, I think, actually. Nice.
He was on the Lone Peak twirl.
Landing's way taller now.
Yeah, I'd say she's 6 feet.
6 feet to meters? 7. If it's 6 feet, 7 meters.
What?
Yeah. That's how it works.
It doesn't.
So the landing's 7 meters tall, which is 6 feet for you Americans.
Because only America does that.
Yeah, we're the only ones doing that feet thing. Let's continue tossing this dirt over then, shall we?
Yep.
Yeah.
So
just toss it on over, Tom. See, this is what it looks like. Oh my gosh. Did you see that? I bet he's going to toss it again. Oh, Tom's tossing it.
Tossing Tom instead of Tom Corn, but that's on the down low.
Ah, the tossing Tom, huh?
Yeah.
No, I didn't even do the outro. Charles, can you do the outro? We're done riding today. Subscribe. We're gonna ride it tomorrow. We're done digging. We're gonna ride the jump tomorrow.
Yeah, dude.
See, Charles did the whole outro.
Yeah.